Today, we are going to discuss about exercise and compare it with enhanced external counterpulsation preventive treatment. When you say healthy lifestyle, some of the terminology which are commonly used are wellness, reversal of heart disease, preventive heart care, anti-aging. And these are all the terminology commonly used to associate with wellness or a healthy lifestyle. Now, there are multiple options available for you to achieve this. One is drugs. Second is probably your vitamin supplementation. And third is diet. But one of the most powerful component which is missing in this equation is physical activity or exercise. So without physical activity or putting yourself under higher level of exertion, vitamin supplementation alone or medication alone or your diet changes alone will not be able to achieve the wellness which you want to achieve. Surprisingly, in spite of that, I clearly said that physical activity of exercise is an important component of wellness. In fact, currently there is no protocol or guideline or evidence-based recommendation to tell you how much exertion you should do on a regular basis based upon your age or your disease status. So there is no guideline. It's very surprising. In spite of there are numerous evidence linking physical activity directly to your mortality. It means why physical activity is important, because many studies, whether it is a smaller studies or larger study with longer follow-up data or epidemiological studies or meta-analysis or randomized control trial, all of them have one component which is powerful, which link your death either because of stroke or heart attack or heart failure or any chronic disease when you are young or aged, all are linked to this physical activities. So physical activities is well established component for wellness. Now, what is the reason this physical activities is directly related to your wellness? If you want to answer this, I think it's a kind of a genetic marker. Physical activity is our genetic marker. Human has evolved millions of years ago, and if you look at the genomic pattern, the genes are which decide your anatomy, physiology and characterization. So if you look at the past 45,000 years, the genome which is present have not changed much. It looks very similar. But what have changed is our physical activity. Now, for an example, if you look at there is one study which says, right now, we do only 35-38% of physical activity which our ancestor does long time ago. Another example to easily put forward so people can understand is a regular 70 kilogram man, or our ancestor, used to walk at least 19 kilometers per day. This level of physical activities is essential for our ancestors who lived long time back, couple of decades back, or I would say like 40,000 years back. Because initially I said that gene has not changed, so our physical activity should not change much. But in fact, our physical activity has drastically changed in the following couple of decades. Now, why there is so much of physical activities before which is not now? Initially, man has to run around for food, for shelter. So for your food and water, they have to run around, and for shelter from your climate or predator. So physical activity is a must. So what nature has done is, it has given up a mechanism. People who have high physical activity live longer. People who have low physical activity live shorter. So this is basically, it's called as an adaptive mechanism, which has been evolved thousands and thousands of years, which cannot be abruptly changed. Now coming to the current scenario. Now if you look at anybody, people say they walk around 45 minutes every day to achieve what they call as an exertion to maintain their cardiovascular status. Now this 45 minutes per day is nowhere near to the 19 kilometers that human were able to do long before. Now, would that 45 minutes is sufficient? Absolutely not. This 45 minutes of regular activity could be very good for people who already have cardiac disease and have a lot of limitation. So exerting to 45 minutes per day, around 3 to 4 hours per week, would be helpful to maintain without progressing the disease, but it cannot act as a preventive. So even the 10,000 steps they do is also nowhere near to the 19 kilometers of walk. So basically now, because of a change in lifestyle, our exercise capability is so low, even if you want to do that, our body would not allow it to achieve that level of activity which you have been used to do it before. Now, this is where the technology comes. Now, could you able to stimulate your body, at least if you are not able to physically do this exertion, can we able to stimulate the body in such a way that the blood flow, everything can be increased, stimulate an aggressive exercise? Now, this is what we are able to achieve with EECP in the preventive cardiology program. So here what we do is, using EECP or enhanced external counterpulsation, it's a non-invasive way of stimulating an exercise. So they place a cuff in your leg and it is synchronized with your EKG so that it increases the blood flow every day 1 hour for a long period of time, for a week together, 3 to 4 weeks or even up to 6 weeks. When they do, what happens is the muscle is stimulated and as well as the blood is also forced to circulate with a higher pressure and velocity because of the cuff compression. When it does, the blood flow can increase to all the organs. It's not only for your heart, it can go to your brain, it can go to your liver, it can go to your kidney, and it can go to your lungs. So all the organs, including your blood vessel itself, can able to see more blood flow coming towards it. So the nutrition, immunity, everything can improve. This is how EECP can act as a passive exercise to stimulate the effect of an exercise, which can play a major role in the prevention and reversal of aging in an EECP preventive cardiac program.